Have you read or watched anything about Gabe Newell working on brain computer interfaces or virtual reality? Actually, that reminds me, I was only talking on the last stream about how somebody asked, what's my favorite fruit? And I said bananas because I like to have a banana smoothie every once in a while. It's actually, I have a banana and peanut butter smoothie. If you've never tried that, give it a go. I know it sounds weird to put peanut butter in a smoothie, but I like it anyway. Banana and peanut butter, the banana smoothies and stuff. And then I saw that the Neuralink bullshit where they trained a fucking chimp, or not a chimp, it's a macaque or something. But anyway, they trained a monkey to play Pong with his mind, and they trained him by giving him a banana smoothie through a pipe looking at the fucking when he was moving the cursor around the screen with his hand, you know? So yeah, I'm just an ape. Yeah, that's me. Just an ape. Fuck Neuralink, oh man, bad vibes. Yeah, I'm in agreement pretty much, yeah. I know I've talked about it in the past. Personally, I'm more interested in it as a thought experiment, as what it reveals about what people enjoy as they play games moment to moment, than I am actually getting one. I'm not getting one. I think there needs to be some kind of massive regulation on shit like that. It's got to be very strict. There's got to be very, very strict, right? Because from what I understand, it the chip it receives, but it's also capable of sending. And if that doesn't freak you out, it should. There needs to be some kind of prohibition on altering a mind through any kind of technology like that in any way, shape, or form. There should be no sending, only receiving, you know? But of course, it won't work out that way because people will be lured in by immortality and stuff. You know, we'll put your head into this thing or whatever. And I just think it's a losing battle. You know, but hey, I'm probably not gonna be alive to see it, so someone else's problem. But yeah, no, it does not seem good. It does not sound it seems like a really bad idea. It's sad because it's one of those things that should be good, you know what I mean? Like, if you could actually trust that they wouldn't fuck with you in any way, it would just be able to send and receive signals along a certain wavelength to like act as a controller in a game and nothing more. You would go, okay, but you can't trust that that's all it's gonna do. You just can't, you know? This was a long time ago. I know I have my little fucking boomer-esque rants about like smart devices and stuff, and it's all fun and games and stuff. But I was thinking about this. I was just thinking about the incompetence and the greed and just the amount of bullshit that they cram into all these devices and all. I was thinking about this a long time ago. The worst way my mind decided to phrase it to me was, they've made me hate the future. They've made me hate it. Like, they've made me actually not want it. You know what I mean? This was something that should have been easy. It should have been something that everybody wanted. I mean, when you were growing up, I was never a big Star Trek guy, right? But I watched a bunch of it. I had nothing against it. Like, I watched a lot of it. It wasn't something that I was like, okay, I gotta go watch Star Trek now because it's on, right? But if it was on TV, I would watch it. And you would watch it as a kid and you would go, man, look at that. They get to just, like, be in the ship and go, computer, tell me such and such. And the computer tells them, right? And I'm not getting an assistant, a voice assistant in my home or something like that. Fuck off. Just fuck off. So you can listen to me and you can tell me, you can shill more fucking crap to me in the cart, you know? It's fucking bullshit. It's just bullshit. It's such a shame that they've ruined the future, you know? That's what they've done. They've actually ruined the future. These corporations. That should have been something that we were looking forward to, and it's not. I mean, who looks at Neuralink? How many people are actually looking at Neuralink and going, oh God, I can't wait for that future? How many? People are just looking at it and going, well, this is inevitable. This is inevitable. Yeah, I suppose this is what's gonna happen, isn't it? You know? Nobody's actually excited for it, at least that I've seen. So, you know, next time you think I'm being over the top giving out about my TV, just remember, they ruined the future on you. They took the future. Yeah, the cool future that you wanted when you were a kid, and they made it shit. That's what they did. That's what the smart TV represents. The cool future made shit.